You know, Berkeley, where I spent more than 24 years there, is a very good example of a public university creating so much for the whole economy. I don't have time to go through the details, but you know, I think every dollar you spend on a university, they will return $7 back to the economy.
在睇片之前，大家记得分享、赞好同订阅卓见名家，最紧要揿埋呢个钟仔，咁你就唔会错过我哋嘅最新影片。
I think this is a great opportunity for us to get together and talk about what we can do jointly. So maybe a little bit Hong Kong, but not too much, okay? So my whole point is that what we can do jointly in the GBA area to utilize research and our universities to make everybody better, right? So you probably know this, that Paul Romer, Nobel laureate in economics, actually have this theory many years ago. I think now actually in mainland, I think we are recognizing the importance of this again. Basically, the main message here is that creativity and knowledge are the main drives for self-improvement and economic growth. This is what they call 新质生产力, right? So basically, you have to recognize the importance of knowledge, creativity, research to make the whole economy grow bigger. Okay, so this is a little bit too much info, but if you look at this, I'm not sure this will work. No, it's not working, so I have to stay here. Here, roughly, you can see that this is what we do. The top part is science and research. This is what we do in any university, right? So we develop new theories and new technology, and then utilize our scientific infrastructure and ideas to lead to startups and innovation. So if you move from the discovery down to the blue side, you will have emerging industry, a lot of startups, and these will feed back to the red part, original science and research. So this is the innovation ecosystem. And we all know that many other areas are doing this really well. For example, the San Francisco Bay Area. So I normally compare the Bay Areas, the Tokyo Bay Area, San Francisco Bay Area, and New York Bay Area, and then us. And actually, I find out that even though we promote so much, but I think we are still lagging behind. Let's face the fact. So if you look at the diagram I have, very importantly, we need to have infrastructure. Are we getting those? Not yet. In our Bay Area, we ranked the last in terms of the major scientific and technological infrastructures. We only have 8, but you can see San Francisco with Stanford and Berkeley and other areas, other universities, they have 34 major infrastructures, right? So I think here we are lagging, and this might lead to less scientific discoveries. There's a really interesting figure there that after 1970, more than 40% of the Nobel Prize in physics actually come from scientific discovery for major scientific infrastructures. So this is something I think we are lacking. Secondly, if you look at the top scientists, we actually are very proud. We have so many really leading scientists here. But if you look at the average, right? If you look at the proportion of the scientists in the general population, again, we are not even on the map. And then if you look at publication, again, we are many of great universities ranked in top 100. But again, if you look at this, look at the proportional number, we are again not on the list, okay? So I think there's even though we are improving really fast, but we are still lagging. And this, I also want to mention this because we, I think Shenzhen is now the number one or number two city in terms of the number of patents. But if you look at, again, the divided by the population, we are not in the top five. Okay? And then even if you look at closely, you know, among all the patents, we have many patents, but not every patent accounts the same. And then there are some patents in the areas of physics and electricity actually create more value, but we are again lagging behind San Francisco Bay Area. So even though we are doing great in terms of the total number of patents, but we are still lagging behind some major categories. And then, we have so many great startups, unicorns, but once again, if you look at the total number, we are, I think, number one, two, three, four, number five, and we are the lowest among all the major Bay Areas. Okay, and then, you know, other things, if you look at the value and revenue from high-tech company, again, we are not the top three, okay? So what's going on? I mean, we thought we are really doing great. We have top universities, we have lots of patents, we have a lot of unicorns. But if you look at this from the global landscape, we still have a lot of work to do. So how do we catch up? Well, very nicely, as we already mentioned, we have great universities here. Not only that, we have many research institutions in the Bay Area too. So if you look at the number, we are number two, just behind New York. So with all these universities and talents here, I'm pretty confident that we can catch up. But we need to work closely together to make this happen. So just give you an example why I mentioned the universities. Because universities should be the center for innovation and the economic growth. If you look at San Francisco Bay Area, which I'm really familiar, there are a lot of important characteristics that make the San Francisco Bay Area leading in many of the major scientific discoveries and economic development. I don't have time to go into all of this, but I also want to mention that if you look at the university in the San Francisco Bay Area, you have Berkeley, Stanford, Davis, and many other universities, right? If you look at this map, actually you can find out that they are at the core center of every activity related to research, innovation, and economic growth. I don't have time to go into the details, but if you look at the major companies, they all have connection with this top university, and they are feeding back, which make Stanford, surpassing every university on the list, starting after the Silicon Valley. So I think we again, in the Great Bay Area, especially in Hong Kong, we have many, many good universities. Can we do something jointly to make something like this happen? Right? Instead of we each cry for help, can we work together? Can we work as a team to make some of the things we are lacking happening? Okay? So this is all I'm trying to promote, is that we should form some forum or consortium or core university forum to make a driving force in this new economy. Okay, so let me just give you another number. Okay, so this is probably common knowledge, and I just get a sign, I only have 4 minutes. So I'll go very quickly go through this. Why universities are so important? First, we are the antennas, right? We are connecting international talents. We know what's happening. Joe just talked about all this ChatGPT and all this. We know this first-handed, right? And then, you know, we can produce all these talents. You know, we know what's going on in the world, and then we can train our students. Many of you already talk about the training of new talents, right? And then we also, you know, have close connection with the industry. I think this is something happening in Hong Kong. You know, with REITs Plus, we can actually working closely with industry, but also pushing our professors to the front. And also, and many of you are already doing better than Hong Kong U, is that we are the hotbed for startups. We can actually produce so many very promising startups. So with this, I just want to show you that, you know, Berkeley, where I spent more than 24 years there, is a very good example of a public university creating so much for the whole economy. I don't have time to go through the details, but you know, I think every dollar you spend on a university, they will return $7 back to the economy. So I have only 2 minutes. And this is, again, a really nice research result I want to share with you, is that I already mentioned that for Berkeley, you put in $1, they return $7. But on average, normally, the more money you spend on a university, the more we will return to the whole economy. So officials, if you are think about giving more money to the universities, that's the right direction to go. I said I won't talk about Hong Kong U, so I'll skip this. We have the Dream On event. Actually, we are catching up to you guys. I know you guys are doing so well. Also, we are building more infrastructures, but this is only for Hong Kong U. Maybe there should be some joint infrastructure for all universities in the Bay Area, right? So we also try to go into this entrepreneur community by inviting a lot of top people to educate our students. I will skip this because this is the same for everybody. My final slide is this, is that I think collectively for the university in the GBA, I think we should try to lobby for more government R&D spending so that you know, we can have more infrastructures and maybe we can train more Nobel Prize winner in pure science. Secondly, you know, with the research findings, we should have a collaborative platform so that, you know, not only we share knowledge among ourselves, but we can also share with the world, with Asia, so that, you know, improve the image of Hong Kong and eventually benefit the whole community in Hong Kong. So with that, I will stop here because a few beautiful ladies are already here. So thank you very much.
鍾意名家分析，记得俾 like 同埋分享，支持同订阅灼见名家。最紧要揿埋呢个钟仔，咁就唔会错过我哋嘅新片。